Apple just released a new app. It's called Apple Invites. It's for iPhone and it's accessible via iCloud.com, where you can create events, invite guests, even invite them to contribute to shared photo albums. And it'll be a great way to organize birthday parties, big game watch parties. It can provide directions and even weather, but it's not completely free. So here's everything you need to know about Apple Invites. The app is free to download. I'll put the link in the video description. It is iPhone only. There's no iPad version right now. To download the app, you do need iOS 18 or later on an iPhone. When you first open it, you'll see these splash screens talking about receiving an invitation or creating an event, then this welcome screen, and you can create your first. Now, I've already created a sample one here, but let's start from scratch. Tapping the plus button in the top right corner, you can add a background image, title, and more information for your event. When you tap Add Background, there's a bunch of pre-made images, photographic, emoji style. You can also upload your own photo, or if you have Apple Intelligence on your iPhone, you can use Image Playgrounds to generate an image from scratch. I'll just tap mountains here, and then we can add a phrase. I added the word teaching because we're learning a new app, and I'll tap done, and it will use that image for the event invite. Let's title the event. You can choose from a couple different font styles. Then we can add a date and time, choose an all day. You can include an end time for the event. The time picker is actually in 15-minute increments, which is nice. It won't let you schedule an event for the past. You have to choose something in the future. Tap done. Then you can also add a description to this event and choose who's hosting it. It'll automatically add your name, but if it's someone else, you can type that here. I'll add a description. Then you also have the option to create a photo album, and everyone that's invited to the event and accepts, they'll be allowed to contribute to that shared album. It'll automatically use the event title for the album name. I'll hit done. Then you'll actually see photos from everyone here in the event. You can also add an Apple Music playlist, and people can contribute that way. I'll create a new playlist here. When we're done, we can preview the event, and this is what guests will see when they receive it, whether they're going, not going, or maybe. The host and description, any shared photos and music. We'll tap next, and then you can share this multiple ways. You can just paste the link somewhere, email it, message it. You can also choose whether or not you need to approve guests or if they'll be able to join automatically. Let's turn that on for now. You can choose from your contacts or tap new guest and type an email from someone not in your contacts. I'll tap a name here. You can choose how you want them to receive it. Then in the top right, you'll see the settings icon, and there's a number of options you can change here. You can choose additional guests, so everyone who accepts the invite can do a plus one all the way up to a plus five. I'll do a plus one. You can remove the background image preview if you don't care for that. You can also duplicate the event if this is something you do regularly, pause replies, cancel, or delete. Let's tap done and see what it looks like to accept this invite. All right, here on the recipient's phone, here's what the invite looks like in the text message using that background image. And when they tap it, if they have the Apple Invites app installed, it'll take them there. Otherwise, they'll be prompted to download it. Here, let's open this invitation. We can get notified about changes to the event. And let's tap that we're going. Because I had that additional guest option, they can choose whether or not they're adding a guest. They can also send a message when they send the reply. Let's say we're going, and you'll see on my device, I got the notification that they responded and they have a plus one. If I tap in, now there's also a QR code that people can scan and get information about the event. Then I can see the guest list and also allow someone else to invite others to the event. Then you see I got the notification here that I can now add or remove guests, and jumping in, I can click the three dots and then share the event from this guest device. You can also add events to your calendar if you would like to do that. Now, if I scroll down, you'll see the link to the playlist, and here's the playlist with some songs I added. Now, it'll play a preview, but if someone's not subscribed to Apple Music, they won't be able to actually listen to the playlist. They do need their own Apple Music subscription. Now, because the event has started, it hit 11:30, it says the event is happening now. And now, as a guest, I can also add photos to that shared photo album. I can also add a comment as I post the photo, but I'll hit post. And now that I added the photo as a guest, when I jump back to that event here, I'll see that photo synced to this shared album. That shared album is also in the Photos app. Now I created another event that's in the future here. I call it the Winter Concert. And I can go back in and edit this event. And let me add something like a location. I can tap location. I can search for a place. I can also name it so it shows differently in the app. I'll tap done. And now it also loads the weather once I added that location. Let me share this invite via AirDrop. I'll tap share link. Then if I accept the invite, I'll tap open invitation. Now this one is actually going to send a request because I said I have to approve guests. I get the notification now on my host device, and you'll see there's one access request. I can tap that. I'll see the request here at the bottom. And then if I approve the guest, they'll get a notification on their phone that they've been accepted. Then I can say I'm going to this event. I'll send my reply. And I can also scroll down, see the weather forecast for that day and the location. And when I tap that, I can get directions to the location of the event automatically. Now you might be wondering what happens if you send an invite to an Android device. They get to see that nice image preview, but when they tap the link And they can actually join the event if they put their email here. I'll put my email, podcast@primarytech.fm. That's my tech podcast with Jason Aten, by the way. New episodes every Thursday. You can subscribe above or the links are down in the description. I got sent a verification code, and you'll see the request was still sent. Back on my host device, I got a notification that there's been a change, and I can get that request from the email address right here. I can approve them. Then I can also view the information for that guest. And that guest will actually get an email once they've been approved. They can open the invitation and they can load that event in their web browser. Now, if you choose to send a note for the event and that person has the Apple Invites app, guests with an iPhone and the app installed, they'll actually get a notification with that note right there. And for those without an iPhone or the app, they'll get an email. Unfortunately, they have to load it in a web browser for them to actually see it. You can also manage your events and invite others on iCloud.com. You'll see it here as an app on your iCloud homepage. And I can manage my events, create a new event. You can also choose whether you get email notifications for events you're hosting and ones you're invited to. I can manage the guests, notes. I can add it to my calendar here and choose whether people can bring those plus ones or twos. Now, it's unclear the maximum amount of guests you can have in an event like this, so let's test it out. I put a link to this event, a Shortcuts live stream. I am actually going to do this. I'll live stream on the YouTube channel. We'll add the link to this event later this week, but you'll find this down in the video description. It's public. Go ahead and join it, and let's see how many guests we can get and if we can crash the Apple invites. Now, here's the one major caveat. The app is free. Those responding can do it via web or in the app for free. They don't need an iCloud Plus subscription or Apple account. But if you want to be able to create events in Apple invites, you do need an iCloud Plus subscription. Overall, though, this is pretty cool. And given that it will work across devices, so you can invite your Android friends, people can respond via email, pretty sweet. So let's test it out. Join my Shortcuts live stream this Thursday. That event invite is down in the description. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel and hit that like button. If you have any questions about Apple invites, leave them in the comments below or let me know. Are you going to use this? Is this a useful thing? I think a lot of parents, birthdays, and kids events, I think it's going to be pretty useful. Also, if you want to see some of the other upgrades that came to iOS 18.3, especially for visual intelligence, I'll put that video right up here. Or if you just want to learn about the 95 plus features that came with iOS 18, which is required for Apple Invites, you can watch that video right up here. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you next time.